Yeah, like we're gonna have to use this. I started recording or something without it. This little sad thing. This is the mic I used to record last time, so my voice is a little bit quieter, but probably that's better for some people, I guess. I don't know, but I've got the overdrive on because there was a scale I wanted to that I was working on, and like I recorded something, but there's no audio for whatever reason. So whatever, yeah, I'm gonna have to record this. It makes all the sounds really it sounds. It makes everything sound really small. Like I'm gonna peak the mic just to fucking do it, I guess. That's one of the, yeah, that serves no purpose, but I don't know. This we'll get this out of the way so that a couple of people basically be safe, I guess. Scary world out there. Supposed massacre in Las Vegas, 200 people dead. Blah 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 blah. Blah blah blah, but then it became 500 people dead by the end of the day. But we'll talk about that later, maybe. Testing. Yeah, you hear me? This quiet ass mic. Gotta like scream into the goddamn thing to even get to mids. Yeah, basically, this is a D mic, directional mic. It's pretty terrible. But it works and I have to talk excessively loud. Nah, fuck it, I'll just talk regular and then I'll like tone it down later. So anyways, news, I guess, more the most pressing news, and I guess in the world of metal, I guess something I have to go into. I have to have something relative. I have to talk about to a degree. Well, first of all, I was messing with a scale that I fucked with earlier today. I was I'm creating one, I guess. Whatever. We'll get to that, but something probably a little bit more important than that. Hold on. Set this down somewhere. No, fuck it. It goes right there into the other room. Onto that, see. Okay. Here to talk about something that probably every person who likes metal has at least come across. It's something called Metallica. I kind of have to in this regard because, like, with people trying to basically xenophobically look for every like way of labeling someone a terrorist or something, you kind of have to be careful nowadays. Like. See, basically this goes back to my previous video about the person named G. I never really had like a see, people, I never really understood the concept of like selling out. You know, like, oh, you have money now, but then people just say you sell out regardless of what you say or do. So I didn't really know anything about that type of crap or whatever. I was just kind of like, whatever. I was still gonna listen to Metallica. So, but the Black Album, it has connotations to G in it, hence the death of, you know, Cliff Burton, etc. Blah blah blah. So basically, if you have like an original
like Metallica album, you have like something of Elektra, like the Elektra branding there. I probably can't even fucking see this low quality thing there. That's all right. We got like a couple of other ones. That little logo down there, Justice for All, a logo right there. This thing right here. It's like maybe I'll put a graphic up, maybe not. It's not really. The point is you can see it. Like that, you can see that it's there. It's not like that weird Mandela effect bullcrap that everybody's on about. No, apparently, like, see this? On Ride the Lightning, because they didn't give me this in like a traditional jewel case. I cut up that weird thing that they give, you know, that weird that like paper sleeve that they give, they put Ride the Lightning in and all these old Metallica albums in. I cut it up. And I just basically force fed it into this CD case in like a very unceremonious fashion. I was just like, fuck it. I was pissed that they gave me that sleeve. There's also on Kill 'Em All, there's also the Elektra album bit. I bring up that Blackened label because you see there, it's a white flag, right? It's synonymous with surrender and all that other type of things, right? Right? On the Injustice for All case, if you have it or whatever, the flag of the like the actual the new case, find it. Ah, fuck it. Basically, it has that blackened label, but it's reversed because Injustice for All would be like the most politically like inflammatory Metallica album, right? Basically, if you have And Justice for All and you're a metalhead and you have the Black Album, and you're like an avid Black Album And Justice for All fan or something like that, you like the roots of progressive metal or something like that, then basically you could be labeled a terrorist. Like the purpose of another thing I wanted to like mention is I wanted to touch on was, is metal satanic? This is tied to the Black Album because we have to go into like things like black metal and talk about that for a moment. Like the answer is no, not really. It's just like any other music. There's satanic country music. There's all sorts of crap like that. There's satanic pop. Like I'm personally not a fan. I don't listen to black metal. You know what I mean? I just don't. I like death metal. I like technical death metal. I listen to Necrophage. I need more Necrophage. Which is, but I mean, like, just, that's just like, you know, I'm talking like metal that is just purely satanic praise crap. Black metal. That stuff. I don't particularly, I'm not into it. But basically, what the Black Album's purpose was for G was to essentially affiliate all metalheads. I think because we have to look at metal as kind of like, what is it like musically? It's kind of a scalar quantity, isn't it? What do I mean by scalar quantity? It means that it has an energy. It's pretty much like it's a large scalar quantity, which means it has a large amount of energy, but it's not. But there's not really a set direction. You know what I mean? Like genres would probably be what you'd call vectors, a direction. Like thrash metal has a certain sound, or whatever, or progressive metal has a certain sound, whatever the hell you want to say. That'd be like a vector. Black metal is a vector. That particular vector is like leads towards Satan's extremes. Like vector versus a scalar. Vector has a direction. Scalar doesn't. As a whole, metal does not have a particular direction, like any form of music. It doesn't. Yeah, basically, if you're a metalhead and you like so, let's say you like black things, you like dark colors, whatever, for whatever reason. basically this could be affiliated with, you know, the Al Qaeda black flag crap. If you have And Justice for All and the Blackout. So just be warned, it's not like you can like actually contest these accusations if they're ever made towards you. It's not like you can bring this to the legal court of law and say, the NSA fucked with me for this, that, and the other because I had the blackout, and this they mistook it for some other affiliation with this, that, and the other. Like, you're not gonna be able to do that. There's no law that allows you to do that. So if you get fucked over because of this, this is just kind of like why this video is here. Like, luckily there is like some good medicine, like because that like the Black Album was part of G's plan to make everyone think that all metal was black metal. All metal is black metal, regardless of what it's about, and regardless of Budgie or shit. I've like, I mean, obviously KMFDM, whatever. Like, just pretty much almost like all, most like Testament, you know? Like, there are people like, so generally, because since it's like extreme territory, they just kind of, metal will, as a result, will sometimes talk about Satanism or something like that, but isn't exactly pro-Satanist or, you know, it's sometimes completely neutral, but mentions Satan or something. Like something like Rush or Black Sabbath or whatever. Like, yeah, like Ozzy just kind of, it's like War Pigs is completely neutral. You know what I mean? It's just like just an observer to, you know, you see what I'm saying? So this is just like, but there is some good medicine, you know, like if you've been affiliated with the snake or whatever, it's kind of like, it's just an excuse for people to basically fuck with you. You say you're affiliated with Satanist extremism to fuck with you on that level, or they can say you're affiliated with Al Qaeda to fuck with you on government level. Even though, like, some of these themes would contradict each other, you know, like, you can't be like a Satanist extremist and an Islamic extremist at the same time. You can't be that. It's just kind of like whatever's on the table plays for some people. So, there is, like, some good medicine, so to speak. I mean, like, I hope he don't mind like me putting him on the spot with this. Is I have some death clock. Like, hold on. Much Death Album 1, oh, Death Album 1, Death Album 2. Sorry, I'm like, I'm talking, I'm moving in reverse. Having dyslexia. Motion dyslexia. But yeah, like, there's the snake right there, with the gear in its head, with the gear in its eye, and a relative better metal snake. So basically, it's a direct reference to this is not Metallica crap. Or Black Album crap, specifically. Like, I've got all the Metallica albums I'm ever gonna get, to my knowledge. Like, I'm good. Like, the Black Album is, to me now, like, I didn't understand as far as, like, relative to the rest of the world, they thought it was selling out because it was going slower. I thought certain songs were, like, just kind of whatever, like, Don't Tread on Me. I was like, okay, it's whatever. But now it's kind of like it's being used almost like an act of war, kind of. And since it's being used as an act of war, I have to kind of just address it. You know what I mean? Like, so those people who are metalheads but don't want to be affiliated with some sort of ridiculous crap because the government's gotten more xenophobic. There's more insanity going on right now. Maybe it's the times. Whatever, whatever, whatever. Not going to go into any of that crap. So, yeah. These two would be medicine for that. Anyone like basically says you're Satanist based on you owning the Black Album and Justice for All can say that you have Death Clock. Don't take yourself all that seriously. And basically, because in Exodus there were two snakes, one that was crafted by the magicians and all that other crap, like to basically serve Ramses III, who is arguably Satan incarnate or something like that. That's take that with a grain of salt. That other part, like, whatever. But the idea is there was another snake, the snake of Moses, which ate that snake. So you can always just say that. You can argue that. So like, no, I'm not Satanist, blah, blah, blah. And I don't take myself that seriously, so you're not that much of an extremist. Right? You're not going to be taken, and no one's going to think you take yourself too seriously if you're listening to Mermaider, a song about mermaid murder. Now, there are some people that might be like, oh, there's some connotation. That's another story for another time. But yeah. I find something worth putting this on, or the Game of the Impash, I'll probably put that on. But yeah. So these would be the medicine for that. Like technical death metal. Save the day in that regard. So yeah. Appreciate you, Brendan Small. So, I don't know. I did want to show you guys this scale I was working on. It's not done by any means. Where did I set that thing now? Oh yeah, by the way, that electro thing or whatever, just for the record, before I forget. No, it hasn't gone through actual copyright law. It's been, Elektra's been essentially retconned out of the Metallica lexicon. Elektra doesn't exist. It's now this blackened. Like, even though that would contradict copyright law, because you have to basically go through the company or whatever to have your copyright renewed. So basically, you would say, like, that the original copyright of Elektra's timeline, and then afterwards it would say blackened. Like, say, Metallica got big. Then they wanted to come back and remaster all their stuff. Now they want to do it all under the Blacken label. But now there's probably a little bit more, like chances suggest that it's a little bit more fucked up than, like, just a copyright oversight for all of their albums. You know what I mean? And the remastering or whatever doesn't go in chronological order. That's just a side note. That's for anybody who's interested in any of that crap. But, essentially, all of the Metallica albums now, there are two, like, it's basically retconned the entire background of Elektra, more or less, with Metallica. So, yeah, basically, the more Metallica you have, the more you could be considered, you know, that scalar quantity. That's referred to, blank, blah, 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 that's bullshit. Basically, it doesn't follow any form of copyright law, but it's blatant, and everybody sees it. That's all. Like, people are going back and changing certain albums, like dressing up old CDs, like new CDs as old, attempting to, it's basically like an intelligence problem, like an intelligence conflict. Like, someone's basically trying to say, it was always under the Blackened album. The entire purpose of Metallica was the Black album. That's what people are trying to push forward. You understand? Like, no, it's... Elektra is, yeah. You see what I'm saying? Existed. Like, you saw the logo there. Probably more easy to send the Master Puppets thing. You got it. Okay. I'm going to look for a pick, and then I'm back. I'll show you the scale. It's not like a riff or anything. It's not like a project. It's a scale that I found that I was working on. So hold on. Okay. So yeah, this just as a reminder, this mic, this little directional mic, is terrible. And it makes this guitar sound quieter. That's I put it on overdrive this time. Like, I'm gonna have to raise the volume of my voice because, like, there's yeah, it's pretty terrible. This microphone is terrible. I'm sorry. It's not very powerful. If it's not terrible, it's not very powerful. So, like the scale I was working on, anyways. Again, not a riff really, and I kind of fucked it up when I was recording without sound for a moment. So, I fuck up. Okay, but it's like I'm trying to keep it in rhythm, but this isn't really, as I said, it's not a riff. This is just a concept. basically, it's a just a concept, more or less. It sounds like from many places, but it's not like what's the word? I'll keep working on it, and then I'll add some more stuff going up the neck, and then and then when I have I don't know. I need to work on another on something. I need to work on something, stuff on there, amongst other things. You can hear you can definitely hear some Iwato in there, like the Japanese thing. The Japanese scale, you can hear that, amongst other things. But yeah, we can. You do this is like a concept. God, this mic is terrible. It really is horrible. It's like. Anyways, so enough of me like a baron embarrassing myself with this thing. I'm gonna open something. Hopefully it's not anthrax. Like the powder, not the band. Season 2, so now it's okay. Maybe it's in here, maybe it's not. Restoration-free packaging. Oh, here it is. Like within this, hidden within it, as a So basically, I'm probably being a bit of a poser, but don't have a vinyl player. But I wanted to get this on vinyl. Just those, you know. Yeah, just want to get it on vinyl. Also have it on this, right? Sense, oops. Metropolis. Yeah, those are the different copyrights. 14 Metropolis, yeah. There's a cover of 1994, Wax Trax. Da-da-da-da. Yeah, it's like, see here, this is an issue from 2014. See what I'm saying? Like, if you have like fucking you have like, let's say you got Metallica's Ride the Lightning 1984, right? That should be under Elektra 1984. There should be a copyright for that. And if there's a reissue, then it'll be for that time when it was reissued. This was reissued 2014. Like original copyright stuff will be here on Wax Trax or whatever, 1994, whatever. But this is like, yeah. In some form or fashion, either you mentioned the previous, like, well, it came to him a bit different because it's like it's always been kind of them, basically, until recently. It's like that's with your music and whatnot. So. Got that, got this. I have not listened to it yet. More tracks on the CD than there are with the the vinyl. Which is important because yeah. Yeah, that's still there. Sorry. Yeah. Like I have a couple of like, because I mean, if we're talking about Came at the Emma, like we're always gonna get into like Anna, like what is it like anachronistic LPs and things of that nature because the timeline's all weird and shit because it's been fucked with. So yeah, I've got one. Something that is how do you say? Oh, I'll just get it. This is like the anachronistic thing that I've got. Like, you know, Wax Trax 1995, etc. That's when the original, yeah, that's when the original copyright was. But it's like, it's remixed by Son of a Gun. You know, so. And there's like Brute, Kunst Remix? You see what I'm saying? But Kunst came out like 2013. So how the hell is this possible? And this obviously came out in 1995 because this is an EP for Nihil, the LP. So this thing is completely anachronistic and makes no fucking sense. But here it is, it exists. Which is fine, and there's nothing like it. Obviously, it was released after the. It's released after Nihil, the LP, was released. This particular version, this particular reissue, whatever it is. But it's like way after, like 2013 or something like that. Like, 2013 for Kunst. And but it has like references to Son of a Gun, which is like the nickname for Steve White was Son of a Gun in World War III, that album, or something like that. So this one's just basically, it's weird. completely anachronistic. This one has pieces that would show up on like on Nihil and stuff, like Trust. But yeah, this is the weird one. Definitely weird. Anyhow, I'll be giving this a listen to later tonight. And yeah, that's pretty much what the, those are the main points I wanted to get across. Oh, and this this bit of a it'll be a pretty bit shorter metal minute than before. Yeah, there's been a massacre in Las Vegas or something like that that supposedly happened the night before. At some time, but over the course of like 8 hours, like, or something. Initially, there were like 200 people dead, according to the words of mouth here, and that there was no information on any news channel. This would be breaking news, right? You know, it'd be like an all-out terrorist attack or something like that. But now it's like it's up to, now the injury toll is up to 500. Basically, see, that's kind of like seeing like hostage siege situations or something like that. There's probably going to be, what do you call it? There's like a drop-off point. Because the thing is, somebody like takes siege and they're there for a while because they have to kill more people, right? But the only way they could kill more people without blowing a building is they didn't hear any reports of any buildings being blown up. So not like, not Trade Center crap. But it's like, how do you say, people would basically have to be funneled into the building for them to kill more people like that. At that point. I mean, if it's like, if you're past like the 8 hour point, and like you go into the 16 hour point, and then like suddenly you have like a an over like 100% like increase from your previous like injury toll or death toll, whatever that might have been, it's like it's nonsensical. Sorry, my D mic is a piece of garbage. I mean, like it's but yeah, basically that there's a point after a siege takes place where the death tolls just drop off. Like people going to the movies. Like there's like a big opening somewhere. It goes down, like after the weekend. Right? That's the drop off, the weekend drop off, whatever you want to call it. Like, or the, yeah. There's that period of time where the death toll, the death rate drops after a siege situation. It has to basically, yeah. It doesn't increase by, you know, over 100%. Like over the course of 16 hours, you know, from the point from the original point where a death toll was already announced, an injury toll was already announced by a news broadcaster. By the time they get there, like terrorists have already made the demands, blah 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 blah, all that shit has already happened. Like the majority of the deaths should have taken place by then, right? So weird stuff in the news. I don't want to talk about it too much, but just be aware. And I don't want any like metalheads who just happen to wear black or whatever getting like fucking somebody saying that they're Al-Qaeda or some kind of crap like that. Some xenophobic asshole using it as an excuse to be to try to fuck with you. That's pretty much it. Yeah, if you have a large Metallica collection, to protect yourself, I suggest getting death albums wanted to. Politically. And again, once more, is metal satanic? Not necessarily. No, it's not. It depends on which artist you're listening to. Some metal is satanic, yes. But not all of it is. And not all of it is like what little it of it is. It's like Satanist extremist, you know what I mean? Like, you know, that like, but Moth, I'm gonna keep that in here. I'm keeping that in here. But most metal is just metal, like somebody making something that they heard or something that sounded cool or brutal or whatever the hell it might have been. I like technical death metal. I like boneyard metal. Basically something that'd be probably appear on Ozzy's Boneyard, more than likely something like Motorhead or Black Sabbath, Rush, whatever. Most of these people just make commentary on things like Satanism because they're usually within the realms of brutality or something like that. So they're usually talking about them or whatever. But it's rare that you find like one that's actually like fucking... I mean, those that are satanic, are you going to fucking bother the people who listen to it? No, you don't listen to it. Yeah, Slayer's, everyone knows Slayer's like Satanist. You don't listen to it. You know that bothers you? You fucking listen to something else. Go somewhere else. I mean, that's freedom of religion and all the other crap. Like, you know, I'm not going to go into all that crap. I've already had too many arguments about this shit. So, I know all rights are being, like, steadily, like, destroyed and that type of stuff. Like, you get, like, you know. It can be hard to deal with some of this crap. I don't know. I'm shooting from the hip here. I'm not like, this isn't like a fucking speech or some shit like that. It's just a fucking YouTube video. But yeah. Just, take care, be safe, whatever. And be careful what you hear on the news. It's getting kind of weird now. Like really weird. Like, if what they're saying is true, then things are going to get really fucked up in the States. And if what they're saying is not true, there's a chance that things are going to get really fucked up here. I mean, for all kinds of different reasons. Like, I mean, it's like, okay. A group of people who can basically rack up a death toll from 200 to 500, basically bringing it up comparable to World Trade Center after that drop-off point, or news channels or news broadcasters are lying outright, using Hollywood to help them with sob stories and things of that nature. Both situations are terrible. And they still haven't said who's responsible for it or whatever, so it's kind of like, anyways, so I'm gonna like mess with this scale once more because I have to be stereotypical and display my horrible skills. But, like, for those who, like, care about this type of stuff, let me know if you see, like, the Hungarian part. Oh, I don't know. I got unclean. Hold on. Alright. So, we're using the dime bucker. Right here, we're using the dime bucker. And, alright, so, just gonna fuck about and see what the hell happens. No, that's the scale I'm fucking with. Oh, if you could see it, I wasn't paying attention to the fucking the camera thing, whatever. So, this has been another fucking metal minute thing. Whatever. This is D, whatever. Yeah, later. Take care. And have fun playing Brutal Legend for the 50th time through.